Okay, so hello and welcome to our second interview. This is Gerd Bölzel from Classic mit Pep, and here is Ottavia Maria Maceratini. And this time, yes, hello. And this time we are doing this interview in English in order to reach also all the Italian public and maybe some other people who don't understand German. And okay. I'm sure that all the people who speak German can also understand us.
I hope so.
Yes.
If not, next time we change again.
Right. And we got so many reactions the last time to our interview that we did. And we are so happy about all your likes and about your reactions. And this really, really encouraged us to continue this interesting meetings and talks. And today we thought to discuss about a very special subject, and this has to do with getting to know oneself and finding out more about oneself through music. This is the subject that we want to talk about. So, and I'm really thrilled about talking with Ottavia because she has so great ideas and the connections she finds out and she gets across is just fantastic.
Thank you.
What do you want to tell us today, Ottavia?
Well, as you thought, there are so many subjects and they are somehow very much connected with each other. And I really don't know where to start from. But let's say that I love this is the way I function. Just I love to think about music as something which is which can take many different directions, depending on what you want from music. And for sure, one possibility is to also use music in order to get to know oneself more. Mm-hmm. And the first reason why it is so is that music can help you get in touch with your own emotions. And this is something very important. And people think that it's so simple, but it's not. Because, you know, sometimes when we play, we get in touch with our emotions. But when you are away from your instrument, maybe, and you are just doing your things in your daily life, somebody comes and asks you, how do you feel? And sometimes you don't know how do you feel. You know, we are used to answer things like, I'm fine. But actually, we are not really answering from a place where we are really in touch with our own emotions. Mm-hmm. And why is it so important? Because I think that the quality of life largely depends on it. The quality of our relationships largely depends on it. Because if we are not able to know what we feel, how we feel, and why, and if we are not able to feel into other people, then relationships are going to be difficult. So music can be a wonderful place where to start, a wonderful training for tuning into ourselves, become more sensitive, and become more able to differentiate different internal states, and then to be able to carry them out, to express them to other people, and then be able to recognize other people's emotions as well.
Very good. So let's see, how can like a musician who has trained, who has practiced music for several years, how he can do that, how he can discover himself, how he can discover his or her own emotions through music. Let's go to some practical application for that.
You know, basically something which I think it can be useful,
yeah,
is to try to describe what you feel also in words. Music is wonderful just because it doesn't use words, you know, and so it can describe and carry out a lot of nuances that we are not even able to label to tell in words. But anyway, it's a very good exercise to make the effort to find words for what you're feeling and how you're feeling, because then, as regards our relationship with other people, this is something which is very useful. And nowadays, what we see sometimes is that young people are not really able to speak about themselves, mm-hmm. to speak about their internal states and how they feel, just because they lack the fundamental vocabulary. And that's crazy. That's something you think it's not possible, but actually it happens. So it takes some training and some effort to be able to build up your vocabulary for your internal states. And this is a source of great pleasure also when you are able to share that part of yourself with other people, because it's something we don't do or don't do so much, or we are afraid to do, or we are ashamed to do. You know, sometimes we share just information sometimes, and it's good, of course, but you know, to share where you are internally is something very valuable, and it could lead us to another way of relating with each other. And I don't speak only about people who are intimate with you, you know. So what I, coming back to your point, you can, for example, playing a piece and then just take out some time for yourself where you just reflect upon how does it make you feel, and what are the associations which come up in yourself. And for example, if you have any, you know, it reminds you of something you lived before, and just dive into it. Have the courage to just dive into it, and then listen to what those emotions are saying to you. Because here is another point. You know, emotions are carrier of some interesting truth. Mm-hmm. No, they are the vehicle through which some parts, very deep parts of yourself, express themselves. And so you can get a lot of very interesting and important messages through your own emotions. You know, for example, let's say you feel angry. And so it's not just about emotion of anger, but that emotion of anger is delivering to you some important message regarding your own life. Maybe it's saying to you, you know, something in your life is being threatened, whether it's objective true or not, but it's for sure it's your subjective truth, it's your personal truth, and therefore it's important to just listen to it. So the anger can tell you, for example, you know, that person is taking so much space in your life, it's invading your space, and so maybe you need to do something. You know, emotions can carry important messages. Or, for example, even sadness. Mm-hmm. Then you dive into your sadness, and then it brings you some important message. You know, what you can become more conscious about what you really need, what you really don't really like in your current life, and so understand what kind of changes need to be made.
Right. You know, yesterday I had another piano lesson with a woman, and she was not playing piano for many months, but she wanted to start again and said, okay, good. And I said, okay. And she starts always again. It's a very drastic phenomenon with this woman. But I love her very much. She's very spiritual. Yeah. And then I said, okay, let's sit down to the piano and let's perceive the room. Good. Now then said, okay, let's perceive the piano in this room. Good. Let's perceive the keys, black, the white, the one in the basso, the one in the discant. And okay, good. Now, how do you feel? Okay, can you express this on the piano? And then she started to play. What I said, okay, just let it flow. Let whatever comes out, let it come out. Yeah. And I felt that there was some sort of unit or some sort of unification between her and the instrument, and this was so nice, and this was basically a new start for her. Yeah. You know, this, and the way she's basically good in expressing her emotions, but not on the piano, but somehow I encouraged her to do that, and she loved this way. She loved to to get in communication with her piano, in communication with her feeling, in communication with herself as a being.
Yeah.
It was beautiful.
Yeah, it's a wonderful what you tell me. Yes, it's just about also coming more in touch with your sense of aliveness also.
Right.
No, and that's why I think it's so fulfilling. And then what is interesting, and it's also that this is a very important subject, that one of being in flow, you know. Everybody desires to be in flow. It's there are a lot of people speaking about that also in finances or in some, you know, firmas, and get into the flow, or in sports. Yes, it's very important. And I think music is a wonderful way and to experience that, to have that kind of experience. But what is even more important than that, I think, is to understand that control and action and non-action are two things that we can somehow manage and do at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we are not used to this kind of thinking. We are very polarized beings, meaning that it's like, you know, you do this or you do that. And we are not used to think we do this and we do that as well. And for example, when you play a piece of music, when you have with any performance or execution, you have on the one hand, you have to, you know, establish a certain amount or degree of control of action. You have to do something while you are on stage. Otherwise you would be just, you know, just, you have to act in some way, but at the same time you have to let go. And so it's so interesting to find this balance between to go for something at the same time to completely let go of something. And music is a wonderful way to experience those states where you are able to unify those different aspects of your consciousness and don't be stuck in this dual way of seeing the world, dual thinking. And it's not easy. It's easier said than done. That's why music can be so valuable, because usually in ordinary life, it's quite difficult to apply that. But when you play, it becomes just a necessity.
Yes.
And so you learn to function, to operate from this different way of perceiving the world, of operating. And then it's very valuable and important if you can apply that, what you learn through music, to your daily life. I mean, that's, for me personally, it's somehow the goal, you know, because I love music, and of course I decided to study it and to give a lot of efforts and energy to music itself. But just because I like it so much, then at some point I ask myself, well, and if one day somebody just takes away my piano, or I am not able to play anymore, what then? And then I discover that music is endless, meaning that what I learn from music, those underlying principles, can be applied just everywhere. And this incredible freedom, this idea is something which gives you incredible freedom and joy.
Absolutely. So I really love talking to you about this subject. It's really marvelous. There was one other subject that we wanted to mention in this talk, and this was basically the sound quality, or the way of producing sound and tone, and how different it is depending on the emotions and depending on your own consciousness.
Yes. Oh, yeah. very interesting as well. What can we say about it? I would start from this. The very fascinating thing about producing sound is that you see that there, how your mind affects reality. And this is something which is more difficult to see in other kinds of environments. You can see that, of course, also in sports, for example, or working on yourself, on your body. You know, you put some intention into some exercises and your body does it. but it takes somehow longer, in my opinion. But with sound, you see the effect of your own mind just directly. It's just like that. You know, depending on your focus, depending on your intention, depending on your idea of the sound you would like to get, you get different results, and just immediately. So it's so fascinating, because there you see how our inner world, our mind, our intention has the ability to produce results on something which is somehow material, because sound is, yes, it's just like matrix somehow, and is vibration, you know. And so I think that's an important principle as well. Again, important principle to apply in other realms of our life, you know, how your intention shapes your own reality. And so but now back to the sound, when you want to produce a certain kind of sound, first of all, what is required is that you are clear in your own internal perception and imagination of sound. And what we here see is how important is imagination as well. Absolutely. Imagination is not just like a childish play. You know, usually when people speak about imagination, it is something, it's like something which is just for children. No, they have imagination and they play with their toys. But imagination is a very important function of the brain. And, you know, through that, we can create actually and ultimately our own reality. But now it's too far. We want to remain by sound and right. Sound production and music. And so imagination is very important to create exactly the kind of sound, music, and interpretation you want to carry out. And if you don't get clarity in yourself, first of all, then there is no way you can achieve a very precise result in your performance.
Very, very good. I think that's a very good point to end off our talk. And I think our listeners have now quite a lot of new ideas to experiment with.
Yeah.
If they're interested, they can always contact you and have a piano lesson with you. You do it either online or offline. And if they're interested, they can always contact you, right?
Yes, of course, anytime. Or we can just remain in contact on this platform, on Zoom, and answer some other questions if there are some.
Right. So thank you very much for this very interesting talk.
And thank you. Pleasure.
Our dear listeners, if you like this interview, just give us a like and give us a comment. And I hope we see each other very, very soon. So, bye-bye.
Bye.